Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to create this 2D drawing from this isometric view or this 3D model. We assembled this model in previous tutorials. I hope you like it. So let's start to create a 2D drawing for a single part or for assembly. I hope you like it. In our last tutorial we created this double V block in SolidWorks, and now today we are going to create a 2D file for whole assembly, as well as we will make parts drawing for one part also. So let's start to create this one. We have two options: either you can directly select new and choose here drawing and OK, but we want to make 2D drawing with the help of this assembly directly. So we have either choose make drawing from assembly. We have one more option here: make drawing from assembly. Now this will ask you, do you want to open this file? I already made this 2D file, so I'll select no, but in fresh case it will not ask you. If I'll choose no, that means it will ask you. Now this is the first pop-up window. It will ask you what size of sheet do you like to use. Here see, I selected only show standard formats. If I unchecked, you will get too many options, but if I checked, I'll get 4 or 5 standard things. So I'll choose here ISO A3 size. Okay, now once you select, now see, this is your A3 size. Now in your left right hand side in drawing section, you will see there are too many things. Either you can choose this one standard view, and here also either if it is not available, you can directly browse your part wherever you saved. Now in the same way, you can model view the same thing. Just click this one and select this one, and it will give you. Okay, let's now see, it is selected one option, front view. If I clicked, see, if I drag, top view, left hand side view. Okay, now this is your main drawing. So click any one. This is your first or parent drawing, so if you change any dimension, it will affect in all views. So I'll first select. Okay, let me choose hidden line visible. So you will see inside line, see, you will see all the threads. Now here I'll choose custom scale, define route, custom scale. I'll choose here 1.8. If you choose change the size, it will make little bigger. If we will keep 1.5, it seems more bigger. So whatever you like, it's your convenience. Okay, now that's it. Now it's time to define this one. So we already saw how to use standard 3 views or model views. Now there is one option, projected views. If you select this projected views, high quality, I'll select this one. Now it will again ask you, see, right hand side bottom view, and then top view. Or if you move your cursor here, you will get isometric view. Click OK. Now let's click this one, high quality. Okay, now you can simply drag it to move in another corner. Okay, now it's time to define the dimension. So we will start with this face. Now here if you go to annotation, you will get first thing dimension. There are too many dimension. If you choose smart dimension, you need to define manually all the dimensions like this, but we will not do this one. We will simply go to and choose baseline dimension. I'll choose this one. then first, second, and this one is already defined. Okay, again we can choose baseline. This is the baseline, then this one, and this is already defined, but we have one more options here. Now that's it. Now let's try the same thing here. Now this time I'll apply here vertical ordinate system. If I'll choose here, it will ask you center point, or even though let's me define this point 0, second line 31.75, third line 38, 4 vertex, that is 70.25 from bottom line, and the last one 108.25. see, this is how it's decided. Okay, baseline, this one, and I'll define this one, and I'll choose this point, this point. Now see, this is how we selected. Even though you can define this point also. Now see, it's going to add all the points here. See, okay, even though manually, let's say, defined anything from here. Or no need, even though there is too many dimensions we already defined. Now simply let's try to set. Okay, now these dimensions are set. Now I'll show you the next thing. Auxiliary view, it's not able to show here. We will see in next. Section view, click section view. Now here 4 types of section view. So we will use basic section view, vertical, and I'll select this, just take it highlight, this center point of this circle, and this is the, okay. Now it will ask you any part do you like to exclude. So we will say no. Auto hatching on, say yes, and once you say yes, it will show you a drawing, a hatching drawing. See, you can move and something like click. Okay, even though you can change the name from here, auto hatching is on. This is front view, dimensions, either you can click if any dimensions initially available on parent drawing, so it will appear here, otherwise it will not. Even though I can change this one. Okay, now if we click on the this hatching line, double click, and this hatching line option will appear. Just uncheck these two boxes, material cross hatch and this apply, and here you can, let's say, change 1.5, apply. Now see, the density will change, or the gap will change in between hatching lines. See, it's become more denser. Okay, okay, that's it. And let's try some more dimension method here. Here we will apply horizontal ordinate system, or let's say baseline. This one, and I'll apply this one. This one. Now all the lines we saw on top, and select the circle. Circle also 50 millimeter from here. Okay. Even though there is one center mark, click center mark and select the circle, and you will get the center point. Okay. Then center distance. Okay, now let me choose here one more option. You will get your whole call out. If you click this one, it will give you 19 millimeter its throughout hole, and we have one counter bore hole, and this is just select this counter bore hole, and it will give you detail. Better to drop down here. Now here shown diameter 8.7, depth 20 millimeter. There is one counter bore hole, and that is 12.7 millimeter, 4 millimeter depth. If you want to see this hole, this is the hole. See, this is the counter bore hole. Outer diameter 12.7 and inner one 8.1, and thickness of outer one is 4 millimeter. So simply select OK. Okay, now this one we created. Let's see some what else we can do it. There is one detailed view option. Click detailed view, and we want to show this detailed view. So I'll select pick one point, let's say higher quality, this point, and draw one circle like this. Okay, now here style, choose broken circle. See, this is B, and here select full outline. So whatever drawing you are going to keep, it will show you in. Okay, that's fine. Okay, now you can separately define this one, smart dimension. So now here we defined this one. Even though either you defined outside hole or inside, it's up to you. And this is the section detail B, scale 2:1:5, and let's say balloon. Either you choose balloon or select auto balloon. So we will choose balloon. What separately we will define. So first I'll choose this. Okay, then okay, let's this one second, and the third one this. See the three balloons we defined. In the same way, we even click on this. Let me drag it somewhere like here. Bill of material. One table appear here. Click OK, and it will gives you description. We don't want, so right click on the description. Delete here column. Now that's fine. You can either moves or something like, you can whatever you can possible do it. Okay, that's fine. Even though you can choose and click bold, oh, that's fine. Now that's the single simple 2D drawing we created. Now let me little adjust this one so that it will comes under the boundary. Okay. Now we have section view and all three views plus auxiliary views, detailed view and table. So even though if you want to change your block title, this is the block title. Just right click on the block title and click edit sheet format, and from here you can double click and you can change like V block assembly. This is too big, so I'll select bold, Italian, color let's say red, and that's it. Now see, in the same way you can change everything from here. This is also too bigger, so double click and change the size 20 millimeter, cancel. Now that's it, this is adjusted. Right click and click here edit sheet. Now we are out of this title block edit. Now the even though if you like to change the thickness of all dimensions, select all the dimensions, one window will appear, pop up here, note. In the note you have to select the last third option, value, leader and other. So I'll choose other. Here you will get one option, text font. Uncheck this box, font. I'll keep bold. Oh, that's fine because no need to increase. Okay. Now from here you can adjust the all dimensions. See, this is symmetric dimension, this is vertical dimensions, this is detailed view. Now let's save it. This is already saved in the same name, so I'll choose one, save. Now in the same way we can try some other part, like we will make drawing for single part. So here at the bottom left hand you will see one option, sheet 1, click add sheet. Now see, this add sheet comes. Now here we will see standard view, click standard view. Now here we don't want this one, we want assembly, any part. So I'll click browse and see, this is the window where our part saves. So I'll choose base, open. Now once you click open, it will see automatically placed all three parts. Projected view, I'll choose this one and I'll draw isometric, click here. Hidden line with edges. Let me drag it. High quality. Now the next thing, we need to define dimensions. Now we will apply here, click dimension, and here we will go to export dimension because this is single part. This applies on single part. Check rapid dimensioning, export dimension, and here we will choose one point. So I'll choose vertex. Now I'll select any one line. It will automatically calculate too many dimensions and it will give you here. Just wait and watch. Select this one, this one, okay, this distance also we need. Now here you will get this option, so just drag it somewhere near. Okay, again choose smart dimension, dimension export, origin point, let's say, okay, let's we will try for this, and let me choose this. Now it's going to calculate. Now see, it's automatically calculate all the dimensions. Now let me select OK and I'll drag this one. Now here you have to do little exercise. You have to adjust all the dimensions separately. Once your PC is going to hang, it makes irritating. Now see, each and every dimension it's mentioned here. See, these all dimensions shows here. In the same way, you can apply dimensions from here also. Smart dimension, dimension export. I'll choose this point. I'll select this dimension. It may calculate or something like. Circle. Okay, now let's adjust those all dimensions. Now this is the top one actually. That's it. So this is the simple thing we did it. If you want to change the scale size, just click on parent drawing and here this is the select modified, click here, let's say 0.5, and if you click somewhere it will reduced, but the 0.5 is too low, so that's fine. Even though the same things you can apply separately, detailed view, click this part here, select broken circle, full outline, click OK, smart dimension, here select smart dimensioning, and here we are defining manual dimensions. Okay, that's it, section view. And even though if you you want to draw some like a section view, this is the center point, you can drag it somewhere like here, you can, let's say, okay, section D. So we will try to move this one somewhere here. So this is your section view. So this is how we can create a 2D drawing for a part or for an assembly. in SolidWorks. It is very easy and very helpful for shop floor. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Thanks for watching.